Well, boys and girls, I am Flipper 55 with Fat Finger Gaming, and welcome! Fat Finger Gaming's continuing coverage of the 2015 college football season. So our season's coming to a close here, at least our simulated season's coming to a close, and here in the Sugar Bowl is number 10 Florida State versus number 13 Auburn. Number 10 Florida State ACC champs, upsetting undefeated Miami. Auburn, upset in the SEC championship by Georgia. We will see if Auburn actually comes out with the inept offense that started the season and was in the SEC championship, or comes out firing like they did closing the regular season.
This is the quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game.
All right, James Winston gets out a nice completion here. So Auburn, Florida State, 2013 national championship. They did actually meet in the absurd 32-team tournament that we had when we revisited the 2014 season. They met in the second round, which Florida State won that one. So as far as Fat Finger is concerned, Florida State has bumped Auburn out of the postseason two straight years. Obviously, this isn't part of the postseason. We will get, I don't know if Auburn and Florida State are even anywhere near the same bracket. But we will see.
He's tackled around the 31-yard line.
The defense was ready for that pass and catch, and they did a good job to hold them for such a short game.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
All right, so Austin, of course, this is going to be brought up the first thing. Did I see... Oh, nice throw to Duke. First down. Did I see the Michigan State-Michigan game? Of course I did. The one thing that I got to say, now I'm going to say this, all Michigan fans, this is not directed towards you. Because you love your team. And all that. And it's very... Anyways, this is not directed towards you. I told you guys last week, Michigan State plus 6.5 is a horrible line. You should take Michigan State and the points and cash in. Now, what I didn't realize, though, what I will say, what I did not realize about the whole thing was I did not realize how good Michigan was going to play. I thought for sure that this was going to be one of those great games that, as gamblers, we all love. In the fact that we put our money down and we sit back, and through most of the game, we are very relaxed knowing that we're going to cash in. I thought for sure Michigan State was going to have a field goal to a 7-point lead throughout the game. Meaning, basically, even if Michigan scored a freaky touchdown at the end of the game and Michigan State lost, we were still covered. Did not realize I was going to have to sweat till towards the end of the game when Michigan State was down by two, and the only thing that was really going to happen was Michigan State may lost, but they would have covered. So I do got to give it to Michigan about that.
Defensive coordinators up late at night, Herbie.
And the other thing that I'm interested about, because I sat back and watched Michigan like really well this time. I watched how they put a lot of pressure on their DBs, and their DBs responded well. Now, that I wouldn't consider Michigan State's wide receivers the best. They're definitely not. I don't think they're the quickest in the world. They do have some size to them. Sort of like, looks like they like the Plexico Burris size, and they've just sort of stuck with it.
What I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it, and that's hard to stop.
But I will, they put a lot of, they put a lot of emphasis on basically needing their wide receivers to play Revis Island, their DBs to play Revis Island. And one of the things as I watched that, I wondered, Blake Countess, graduate transfer to Auburn. Did he transfer because he wanted to be on a national championship contender and wanted to get away from, you know, the turmoil that would be John Harbaugh coming in? Now, John Harbaugh obviously coming in is going to be a hell of a lot better for you as far as the pro standings are concerned. But did he transfer because of that? Or did he transfer because he couldn't play that way and he knew his senior season he was going to be sitting on the bench? It was just something that came to mind. Now, I don't know if that really ever came to his mind or not, but watching what they tasked the Michigan cornerbacks to do, I don't know. It makes a hell of a lot better explanation for the way Auburn has looked. That's for sure on defense. Got the ball out to the flats, but the ball was ripped out of there. Auburn in this simulation has had one of the best defenses in the nation. Very, 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 very shocked and surprised with that SEC championship game in which Auburn lost to Georgia 30-7. A little bit due to their inept offense. Their offense went back to basically how they started the season, not the way they finished. The last eight games in which they all won, they looked amazing. Florida State, on the other hand, Golson was unstoppable in the ACC championship. Had he played like that, they would have been undefeated throughout the season. Austin writes in talking about the fact that, you know, Michigan can always stick it to Ohio State. Their season isn't over yet. And there's two comments about that. One thing is, I don't think they will. I think Fat Finger Gaming simulation of them going 8-4, I think is going to be right. And the thing is, and I had wondered about this before, I really think that Michigan fans, at the end of the day, when we get done with the season, if they go 8-4, especially if they go out the Fat Finger way, in which basically they were shut out by Ohio State, then yeah, they'll feel like it's a disappointment. But I honestly think that if they do go 8-4, which is great for the turmoil that Michigan's been in. For this to be your rebuilding year. And they make the stop. Oh, Peyton Barber can't get to the outside and get that first down. I think Michigan fans are going to be disappointed. I do. And I think that's going to be... Wilson. It's going to be unfortunate. Unrealistic and unfortunate.
From the 15... He makes it to the 25-yard line. Well, this is just a defensive battle so far, Kirk.
Yeah. This is the same simulation that has Auburn 13. Yeah. Also same simulation that had Wisconsin beating Alabama and Louisville beating Auburn at the very start of the season.
Florida State has a three-point lead.
We'll see at the end of the season. I am very curious to see how much, as far as conference champions, division champions, not individual games. I knew individual games was going to be messed up. I'm very curious to see what, if any, Fat Finger has. Hell, you didn't even bring up, you got Auburn at 13. You didn't bring up the fact that Oregon made the college football playoffs. Playoffs. Fires incomplete. But I'll be interested. Oregon winning the SEC championship, yeah, probably is not going to happen.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
Wow. Got defense galore here.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. This one is a beauty. Gets to about the 34-yard line. Got to wonder right now which offense is going to open this thing up a little bit.
I think the answer will be which offensive coordinator is willing to take a chance or two to try to open some plays up. Because right now, not only are they losing the battle.
All right, so 3-0. Are we actually going to end the first half 3-0? Actually, this one brings back memories of their 2013 national championship. I don't remember what it was at the end of the first quarter, but I do remember both teams came out very... I remember there was a couple drop balls. They came out very tight, in which a lot of teams are doing that lately.
Gaines is right in midfield. When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working. That makes it first and 10.
Jeremy Johnson gonna get 9 yards on that. There we go. Wake.
The Seminoles with a 3-point lead, and we're ready for more football here.
Yeah, no game at all. This wake keeps going on. Wake, did you? I think you unfollowed me. You jackass. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Here, I'm putting this up. The reason why I said that is I actually had to look for you. I think... Yeah. So, Wake, the 32-team playoff is coming up. And I did the brackets. We're doing the 32-team playoff. We start next week on Monday. I got the bracket up. And, what am I trying to say? Oh, I did the bracket. If you do what the instructions tell you, you can get on there and do your own brackets. And the reason why I think you unfollowed me is because I actually had to go through my. Did I find? No, I didn't even. I don't think you ever followed me, you bastard. That's what happened. I went through my emails. I couldn't find you. I'm like, what the hell? So I had to type in Twitch to figure out what your username was. Because I got to manually put in the usernames. Because of security issues. Or I said that one. So I'll get around to it some other time to talk about that.
Florida State is up a field goal. He's taken down at the 41-yard line. That's good for 14 yards. First down.
Coming to you. Mike 8. So once again, to the Twitch followers, especially only the Twitch followers.
And down he goes around the 32-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
Only the Twitch followers I knew were on Twitch chat. Because of the way I had to do security, I made sure to get the usernames that I remember seeing regularly on the Twitch chat to make sure that they had openings for so they could fill out their brackets. If anybody else comes in there. And I just heard a ding on my phone. Was that Wake with a follow? That'd be too damn funny.
Tight end incomplete. Curve was the intended
There you go. Week FU. There you go. Thanks for the follow. You've been on here for months. Anyways, well, I knew you'd be on, so I figured if anybody deserves to be able to get a chance to pick out their own brackets but not a follower, it definitely would be Wake. Okay, what's the brackets for? The brackets, we are going to take this 2015 season. I always wanted my dynasty, this is part of a dynasty, and I always wanted my dynasties to end in a 32-team playoff, an absurd 32-team playoff. So what's going to happen with this dynasty is we're just playing out for real this bowl season. Starting Monday, however, we're going to, oh my God! Starting Monday, we are going to actually start the real 32-team playoff. So Auburn and Florida State, they're in the 32-team playoff, and all the brackets have been done. And so you can get on with it. You can prophesize, and it's going to be all these teams. If a player is hurt, like Rock Thomas is hurt here, and so he will be hurt for the playoffs. It's basically it's a 32-team playoff to end our 2015 season.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards, and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, everywhere we go when we travel over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread, or the pistol, hurry up, tempo offense, and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing defense. And when it's all said and done,
there we go. Just Auburn. Yeah, Auburn. Auburn, Alabama. Do they really play that early? Or I can't remember. I don't have the brackets offhand in front of me. I can't remember where they're supposed to play. When they're supposed to play. I guess I could throw it up on my computer, huh? I could if I really wanted to.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He airs it out.
Oh, Jeremy Johnson gunned it. Duke to 20. The 10 touchdown, Auburn.
Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points.
There we go. So we got it within 3 here in the Sugar Bowl.
75-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Personal foul.
Austin's reading Trunk stories from Michigan fans. Yeah, no, you probably, that probably reads pretty badly.
Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing.
Wait, glad Michigan lost. Still want them to beat Ohio State. Yep, I gotcha.
These wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks.
You know, the worst part about that final play, if he gets tackled anywhere from when he caught the ball to the 10-yard line, they can kick a field goal and win. If he gets tackled within the 10 to goal line, time runs out and they lose. So there's like a 10-yard period there in which, oh my, Mario, getting on out there. Mario.
It puts a seed of doubt in their mind.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air.
Mike eight.
Strings it out left and he stopped right away. God bless America. No. U-boat, you. No. If the punter falls on the ball, Michigan State has a chance for a 50-yard field goal to win the game. And there was still 16 seconds left. Or, like, I don't know. There was still time on the clock. I don't know if you could have had an out to get him closer or not, but the punter still would have had 50, you know, they still would have had a chance to kick a 50-yard field goal for the win.
Nice play to set up first and goal. First down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Yeah, OU. Now, here's the thing with Oklahoma. I was talking about it, the big Kansas deal about it. You know, he texted me during the game. He's like, where was this Oklahoma squad, you know, with Texas? Stuff like that happens all the time. Oklahoma was my pick and still is my pick for the Big 12. They are. Just because a tech team that likes to beat them when they're unranked beat them doesn't mean a thing to me. Those rivalry games don't mean a thing to me. As far as Memphis versus everybody. Thanks for the follow. Oh, nice. The Tigers on the island of one. That's awesome. And, of course, our resident Auburn fan, the stream is cutting. It always is. Biggest upset this year, Spurrier retiring before Bill Snyder. That's actually really funny. That is too damn funny. Who's a bigger disappointment, Georgia Tech or Auburn? Auburn, definitely. That's from Austin. Wake was with the biggest upset. Spurrier retired before Bill Snyder. That is really, really funny. Austin, the biggest disappointment, Georgia Tech or Auburn? Definitely Auburn. Biggest game of the year, Memphis versus Temple. Ain't nothing happened to Ole Miss, man. Memphis happened to him. Winner of Memphis Temple going to the semis. They're going to be... Look, you saw it here on Fat Finger Gaming. Temple winning the American, beating an undefeated Navy team. Temple's for real, man. Okay, maybe they're not for real, but it doesn't matter.
Getting better with each series, and you know this game started where this team was. You know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense, and I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said, they seem to be growing with
from Wake. Ole Miss prepared all season to beat one team. Completely forgot about everybody else. Like, yep, we are going to game plan. I'm starting from right now. Oh my God! Speaking of game plan,
tosses across the middle to his tight end. Tackle at the 34-yard line.
Speaking of, speaking of game plan, Steve Young today before the Monday night game. Absolutely hysterical. Trent Dilfer started out with a joke that he was picking the Colts because they had this great fake punt play. And Steve Young picked up with it and was talking like he was Chuck Pagano. And he was like, guys, why'd you even run that play? I wrote it on the board as a joke. Why did we even run? Oh, God. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Canada versus USA, NHL 15, nice. Impressive game there by what Dilfer is, Dilfer does just a fine role. But I did like Steve Young sitting there saying, hey, dude, I wrote it on the board. That was a joke. Why did we even run that? Oh, God. That's what happened there. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Got his receiver, but it's knocked out. All right, so FSU cleaning the house here, looking good. Third down now. They need to get it down. Wonder if they will look this good in the 32-team playoff we're going to start Monday. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. They'll wrestle him down to the backfield. Auburn just took their first timeout. They lose 3 yards there. They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. Yeah, I like Mike. I really do like Mike. But he's turned into like the fuddy-duddy old man. Hell, he wears. I mean, it just adds to the look, him wearing sneakers with a suit. What do they have in store this time out? I think ESPN's crew is if they didn't have CC and Key are pretty funny together. If they didn't have CC, I probably would never even care to check in once. I do like Mike, but I no longer care for what he has to say about football. Around the 31-yard line, the Tigers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. From their own 31-yard line. Second down. Oh, come on. Austin getting on Hervey for commentating the OSU game. You can only watch 5 minutes of it. Wake responds to what's wrong with a booster from a school calling their games. That's awesome.
When you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. He's wrapped up for the sack.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense.
Oh, my God. Temple. On. Really? Temple versus Notre Dame is prime time? That's too funny. As they head to the locker rooms. All right, so here we go. 17-7. FSU. All right, Reese and David. Welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. And the war chant. No. This one's going to be down. I've heard well enough of that damn thing. Listening to the Braves on TBS.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect.
Used to date a Braves fan. There's got to be some sense of urgency. Been at a couple, more than a couple Braves games. And then, of course, we have Florida State. Been to, I've only been to one NC State Florida State game. That was the one that we first won. Which made the second ACC loss to Florida State. This coming from Wake. Who plays Wake NC State this weekend? It escapes my memory. Yeah, dude. I'm not looking forward to it. Anybody who does not know, NC State and Wake Forest are playing this weekend.
And he's tackled right away.
I would. The Tigers. I don't know. I don't even want to discuss it. I really don't.
Wilson.
Because I have this feeling Wake is going to be giddy to get on Monday just to type just one thing. Neither one of us are looking forward to it.
It's a new possession.
Oh, God.
So what will it hold?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, the thing that's going to happen this weekend is one team's going to prove just how bad they are. I really firmly believe it.
It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Both teams might. I don't know. We might have a 6-3 game on our hands. Thank God there's only one team in that weekend that has actually done that. And it's not NC State. Austin Gamers, OU's got TCU, Baylor, and Okie State in a row. I know, talking about leaving everybody to the back. That's going to be a bad way to end the game and end the season.
It's second down.
Our resident Auburn fan. If your arms are in a chopping motion, that means you're a true Atlanta Braves fan or Florida State fan. And Austin writes in, or Chiefs fan, which is true. Or in physical therapy from Wake. Austin, platinum or karate master. Yeah, Austin, I don't know. I don't think you actually.
It's intercepted.
Oh, God, the Twitch jet. It ends with Austin saying, or an actual Indian fan. And, of course, Wake says, that's racist. I love it. Or an actual Indian. Oh, boy. Good pick by Auburn, trying to stave off going down 3 scores here to FSU here in the Sugar Bowl that actually is going on while we're doing the Twitch chat. Nugget. Nice.
At the 35. Big gain there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big gain.
Everybody bunched up tight defensively.
Hey, man, I'm at Oklahoma. I know a bit about Indians. Yeah, Okay, buddy. Oh, geez.
That makes it first and 10. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. He's knocked out of bounds.
I swear my computer is slow.
A short yardage defense here. Tackle made around the 20-yard line.
That is a loss of 7 on the play. That'll make it second and long.
Uh-huh.
From the 20.
Oh, resident Auburn man. My great-grandmother is full-blood Cherokee. Well, dude, if I were you, try to prove that any way you possibly can and try to see how much money you can get to go to school. And I'm not kidding. Nice touchdown there. Goes within 3. You get a lot of... There are a lot of perks. Even just proving you're an 8th. of an Indian, you might as well, without it, sorry, Native American.
So that's a 6-play, 93-yard drive.
And you need to take advantage of it.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
So the score now, 17-14. Tackle made at the 26-yard line. Florida State's offense was rolling along earlier, and now they have gone ice cold in the third quarter.
Brad, they almost look like a different team. It's like they've come
Platinum, if you're still out there next week, we'll see if they start the 32-team playoff using these 2015 rosters, using the same teams that we have been using throughout the simulation since July. We expand this bad boy out into an absurd 32-team playoff. You can fill out your bracket. I have you in there now.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Florida State is up by three. He might have a chance. They get about four on that keeper.
I think I have you in there. You should be in there now. I actually, you know what, Austin? I did not catch Spurrier on game day. I am sure he was a blast. I am sure he will be a blast. I am sure he will say things that no other person would actually say about another coach. Just because, you know, all those guys want to interview. See, that's the catch 22 when you're a commentator.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
Oh, you both don't worry about it. I don't know if that was sarcasm or not. The password doesn't work. You could actually put in there flipping waffles, and it's really not going to matter if you put it in the password when you sign in. Trust me. It's a form on there that was the original form that I created to get everybody signed in, and I don't, just whatever you do, I don't think hit register. Without a doubt, don't hit register. I don't even know what function it'll take it to. Hopefully it just drops. I think I cut ties with that. But anyways, I had a whole big thing done up, and like I said, the security, I thought I was good, and then I'm reading all these things, and basically people laughing at the fact that, you know, the security function that I'm using is basically straight out of, you know, the 1920s, and a 12-year-old with a iPad could hack it, yada, yada, yada. So I was like, I don't want to be responsible for anybody's information now. Because I was going to do, there was a lot of things that I want to do. Wait, Pops in here, how'd you know my password was flipping waffles? That's awesome. There were a lot of things that I want to do.
He gets rid of this one.
And certain things, like law, tells me that I have to make sure people are older than 18, and a bunch of other things that I wanted to do.
Can tie it up here with this kick.
So that's the reason why I was making everybody register. What I was going to make everybody register and yada, 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 yada. But until I can get a good security thing,
success for this offense on their last trip out.
It is what it is.
Is up a field goal. He goes downtown. Almost picked off.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his paw right in the passing.
But it's there. And there are a couple interesting little bugs. You can look back through the history of just 2014, and we'll keep on doing it. That little drop down menu is hysterical. Like, it won't take you to 2014. It's some kind of bug. Basically, what you'd have to do, if you're in 2015, I think you click on 2015 and then drop it down, click on 2014, drop it down, click on 2014, and it takes you to 2014. You have to do, like, the reverse to go back. I don't know why the bug's in there. I don't care. Once again, it is all free to you guys. If I was getting a client, I'd be extremely thoroughly embarrassed, but I don't care. I do care. I want it to run smoothly. Don't get me wrong. I do care. I do want it to run smoothly. However, it can launch with a whole bunch of bugs that don't work right. Let's put it that way. I mean, hell, you guys pay for EA games all the time that come out with huge bugs, so, you know.
The defense defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
That's actually what it brought, bring back the discussion I had a while ago about YouTubers and Twitch guys, and it's more YouTubers. The audience, most of the YouTubers that I watch don't have a whatever plus, so they don't have a subscription-based channel, so they're not paying for that channel. I'm not paying to watch the channel. The only thing I'm paying for is internet. But I do think it's fun. I do think it's funny anytime that damn YouTube comments, like, you write in these stupid things like,
as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Criticism as if you're actually paying for the stuff, which is just too damn funny.
Brought down at the 33.
YouTubers do get paid, but they get paid mostly for ad revenue. If they do get paid, like Twitch, you can do subscriptions. If you actually pay for that channel and money goes directly from you to the Twitch guy, the Twitch streamer, and or the YouTuber, yet you have fun bitching. I don't have a problem with that. Have fun all you want. Where's Davin Cook? You know what? I don't know. Well, Delvin, sorry about that. He was in the ACC championship.
Wilson will be the return man.
Mario Pender is actually in this roster. Mario Pender is the starting running back. I know that. But Delvin Cook was in the ACC championship, so he's on the roster.
That's what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. This was an error that should have been avoided.
Wake, ironically, Wake Dynasty is about to play Florida in the national championship revenge time.
Has a 3-point lead.
Wake, I think you should honor the fat finger simulation by only kicking field goals and see if you can win.
That makes it second and 10. From their own 38-yard line, second down.
Oh, Wake. So... So, Wake, for my playoffs, I'm not going to tell you who I picked to win, but it starts with an N and ends with a Y. This is coming from a guy who regularly said if Navy doesn't win, the terrorists win. Or if Navy doesn't get in, because I didn't have him in the 14 playoff. Good game here, by the way, 17-14. Florida State up by three. Dude, I was going to make a sign about good old John Hendrick, the third string quarterback for Navy. We were talking about, should go for president because he's got such a strong name. I was actually going to make that campaign sign, and in little tiny letters underneath, put Temple Trains Terrorists. And I sat there and thought about it, and I was like, nah, we're not going to go there. Because these are one of those things, like, you post online, and all of a sudden you realize, like, per capita, per student, Temple has the most Arab students in all of the United States or something like that. And you start getting people bad and in trouble and all that just for an NCAA game that people don't realize the fun of Wake saying the terrorists win if Navy doesn't win. And, oh, God. That's how things get out of hand. Funny, though. Austin, Nebraska. That's awesome. Northern Illinois. Oh, North Carolina State. There you go.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw, and down he goes.
Actually, North Kakalaki. I mean, that does. Well, actually, I think it ends in an E, but that's besides the point. Oh, Austin. There you go. Northwestern University. That doesn't. That definitely starts with an N and ends with a Y.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone.
All right, down by three. Jerry Johnson got to bring his team down the field here. Plenty of time for both teams to make what they need to of this game. But obviously, when you get a chance, you might as well go ahead and just take it down the field and score. Get the win.
They'll get him for a loss.
Yeah, you got to look. Oh, wide open down the middle of the field. There you go. We're in field goal range. Auburn got a chance to tie this game. Yeah, Northwestern getting ranked. The reason why Northwestern had to get ranked was it had to back up the assumption that Stanford should be ranked high. Which backs up the assumption that USC should be ranked high, in that the Pac-12 actually has better teams than you think. I mean, that's sort of the difference between... That's not the only difference, but that is the difference between me and the national writers. Is I told you that the ACC would come out with teams better than you think they would come out. And so... National writers, what they get to do when one of their conferences that they're trying to back hard loses to somebody else, well, they just can pump the other guy up. Me, I don't have anything to stand on.
Throws it in a hurry. Touchdown, and that's going to give them the lead.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all. And he converts the extra point. Carlson gets set to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. Cook. From the one, tackle at the 20-yard line.
So Auburn takes the lead, 21-17, 5 minutes left to go in the game. Florida State now looking. They've actually had a pretty good hold over this game throughout it. They just were not able to connect that interception in the second quarter, of course, weighing hard on them because they could have gone up 24-7.
Let's hope that's nothing serious.
I think that's Mario, who actually is who is hurt, so we should see Dalvin Cook here. I don't know. Oh, that's going to be picked off by Countess. Blake Countess with a... The graduate transfer we were talking about right there. Big pick there. And that could bring this to an end. All they got to do is get this bad boy into the end zone.
27-yard line. It's first down. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Auburn is up by four. Quick pass, and he tackles him hard at the 12-yard line.
Gain of 14 yards. First down.
Jeremy Johnson, 17 for 23, 300 yards, 3 touchdowns, 1 interception. That is huge.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That is huge. Second and 3 here. They put this into the end zone, and they will be Sugar Bowl champs. There's no way Florida – well, there is a way. There you go. Nice throw there to Marcus Davis. That's 4 touchdowns on the day for Jeremy Johnson. Where was this in the SEC championship, folks?
That's touchdown pass number 4 of the game.
Had they done this, they would have been heading to the Orange Bowl.
That's the main reason he's been able
instead of Georgia.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Auburn's defense, they've got the it factor.
The it factor, the swagger.
So this is the reason why I was telling you that they're my resident Auburn fan. I mean,
they play like they know they're going to stop.
In the 32-team playoff,
love to make amends for that last pick.
The first rule on offense is to take
Auburn won't be that bad of a pick.
They
got a great defense.
There's a strike complete.
I'm not quite sure. Once again, I don't have the brackets on me. I probably will open up in between games.
From their own 24-yard
afraid of me opening up brackets and just crashing my computer. Worst stuff has happened.
And a quick throw. They'll bring him down right around the 26-yard line.
So if I crash the stream in between games, I'm all right with that. Stream can always be brought up easily. Golson firing off his back foot. Not going to do it. 4th and 9, 2:55. Obviously, they've got to go for it.
That'll bring up 4th and 9. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
I forgot U-Boat 47 was an Arkansas fan. Arkansas's winning the entire tourney.
And down he goes.
Wake response. Weird way to spell Navy. Nice. I think I got Arkansas going out in the first round. If you were actually when you're on the brackets, if you actually click Flipper's brackets, it'll take you to my picks. Now the thing is, to get back to your picks, you've got to go back to the home and type in the sign in your username to get you back to your brackets. I know, it's a pain in the butt, but once again, it's free. It's not completely done yet. Who knows when it'll ever be done.
He's at the 30, makes it out to about the 29. The Seminoles call a timeout.
I haven't played NHL hockey in, I don't know, I think 13 is the last time I played it.
Ball of the 29.
And that was just because it's actually the last year I played in friends and family golf tournament I play in every year. Fortunately, the last 2 years I haven't been able to play. But on my way up there, normally we get into this big NHL tournament in which, you know, two players on each side, and we have teams and we drink and we fight, yada yada yada. And so basically, like, the first night's normally just like the NHL championship. The NHL, we just play NHL. And I wound up buying it used on my way up to the tournament.
Get 7 yards on the play.
And so the first night, all we do is drink and play. And the golf course, and then after the golf course, we drink till 2 o'clock in the morning. And then we go out to the golf course again and drink till 2 o'clock in the morning. That's the way the golf tournament is.
Tackled after decent pickup. Gain of 4 yards. That makes it first and goal. And this is the 8th play of the drive.
So will Auburn run it in here and run up the score? Nah, all right. They're going to kneel on it.
The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team.
And Auburn will win the Sugar Bowl. Normally reserved for SEC champions, but we'll say SEC champions runner-up, which is actually funny because the Rose Bowl will be between Wisconsin and USC, both runner-up in their conference games.
So what are your final thoughts on this one, Kurt?
Well, speaking of which, what game do you want to see next? We either have the Rose Bowl, which is Wisconsin and USC, or we have the Fiesta Bowl, which will be Ohio State Miami. I think that's Fiesta. I'm pretty sure that's Fiesta Bowl. Take a little look here at the stats before we leave. Oop. Don't need to see scoring. 325 yards, 4 touchdowns, 1 interception. My God, Jeremy Johnson, had you done that in the SEC Championship, you would have won. Barber adds in 145 yards. Jeez. Wow. On the opposite side, Golson has just the opposite effect. He was extremely good in the ACC Championship. This time, just 61% completion, 220 yards, 1 touchdown, 2 picks. Pender can't get anything going. We didn't see Dalvin Cook, and I don't know why.